Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to make a Griselda sample beat right inside of FL Studio. You will see every single step. If you don't know me, I'm Game from BusyWorksBeats.com. We trained over a million producers around the world. Some are going to work with Drake, Kanye West, Post Malone, Ariana Grande, French Montana, Young Thug, Lil Baby, Polo G, Trippy Red, J. Cole, Kendrick Lamar, long list of folks. So I'm going to give you guys the project files for free. I'm going to record some piano here and we're going to chop our own piano as if it's a record. So let's record this in. I'm recording to the metronome here. I'm using a Korg Kronos for the sound. So firstly, we're going to play D minor, D as the bass and then A minor up top. Then we're going to play E at the bass and then play this chord. And then we're going to go to F. We're just playing F and then F major. And then we're going to... And then A. Play that. So I'll just sample all those chords so that we have something to chop. Maybe 3 bars. Maybe 4 bars. Let's do 4 bars. Now we're at F under F major. Then we're gonna play some kind of inversion here. I don't feel like mapping it out. We're just gonna play it. It's very tense. And then we're gonna play, I believe this is like an A major chord. I've created my own chord structure here. Gonna let this ride out. Now that's a very luxurious chord for a Griselda beat, but we might be able to use it. Also, let's try some suspended chords. So let's do a darker take this time. So I'm just playing D suspended second here, and then we're gonna go to D minor, and then I'll do some kind of chord over top of a chord. So that's regular D minor. Let's try this chord. It may or may not sound good, but let's try it. It's pretty dark. Let's add D in the bass and A minor up top, which is D minor ninth without the third. More Drake-ish vibe on that one. And lastly, let's end on some like, kind of like lush type of chord. Okay, so now we can pull from these chord types. So let me let it ring out and then we will sample ourselves and build something over top of this. All right, so now we have the chords. Let me think here. How can we combine this? I think you can combine this in FL Studio. If you highlight it, hit Control G, it will like re-render it to audio. All right, it was worth the wait. So now we have it as one clip. Let's double click in here, right click. Let's open this up in slice. Reason we're doing it here is because we could do dull slicing. It will automatically slice. Now that's pretty, it's too much slice going on. So let's go to the regions tab. Let's go to auto slice. Let's do dull slicing. This should be a little bit better. And now we can go to our type and keyboard icon up here, right click, select layout slice C4. So now I can use my type and keyboard to trigger those slices. So if I go to slice, now we can pull from. Okay, so we can do cool stuff like. Okay, so I could do like, and get dark really quick. So let's try that. Now, I like to do my drums first and wrap the music around the drums because drums are hard to reprogram after you do your music. So I think we found some drums here. Let's open these up and slice. Here, we're gonna click the auto slice icon. We're gonna right click our typing keyboard, go to layout slice C4. So here, again, you just play by hand. The difference here, the short answer is that people who use MPCs have velocity control. People who use their typing keyboard don't. And the main difference you're going to get is it's not as much dynamic. But even still, in the real drum recording, you know, the dynamic's already in the recording. So you don't really need velocity control as much. So let's find our hi-hats. I like to record the hi-hats first. So let's do something like this. Let's go to like 84 BPM, 88, somewhere around there. 88 is kind of fast, but let's start here. Okay, so I did it by hand because I want to feel like we have a real drummer. So let's do this. Nextly, let's add our snare. Now this sliced it wrong, so we're gonna have to manually go in and edit the snare. It should be like, should have like a longer tail. What I might do, let me think, this might be easier. What I will do is let's open the actual sample in an audio editor. I'm just gonna slice out the snare I want. I wanna keep the snare consistently one snare unless I plan to add snare rolls. I don't plan to add snare rolls, so we want just that snare. So what I'll do is I'll manually slice it. And then we could just draw it in our channel rack. That way we don't deal with all this like slice error stuff that it did. Let's drag this into the channel rack because it has a lot of reverb on it. So I want that sound. So let's add that on our 2 and our 4 in the channel rack. Drag that into the playlist. Okay, so now we have that full snare. Okay, now let's go back and add our kicks. Now let's just get a groove going. Now this is a very danceable rhythm that I'm making here. Keep in mind those kicks are not just playing by themselves, they have some kind of cymbal over top. So you have to play it according to the rhythm of the track. So go stick ching ching. So they're just like hi-hats. You gotta be careful with the kicks with stuff over top. Just for this groove, we're gonna quantize hitting Alt-Q. That way it's not too loose. Now let's start adding a dark vibe to it. Probably gonna slow this down. It's a little fast. So let's go to 84 BPM. Another technique, if you slow down your sample, you could also pitch down your drums here in the top left. Because in the olden days, they would have to speed up drums and then slow them back down. So we're gonna slow down the drums to give it like an artifact. We don't have to do it though. Let's just leave it normal until we need more vibe. Okay, so now I'm gonna use my keyboard. Actually, we sampled our keyboard, duh. Forgot. Let's add these. So I wanted to just go ba boom boom ch da dum dum and just repeat that. So what I'll do, this is like really advanced here, but because the drum has a tambourine over top of the kick, I don't want that for this specific lineup. So we're going to add a low pass filter under articulator one, which is the default filter. And we're going to cut out the highs so that we don't have that tambourine. Now let's add more sounds over top. All right, so we're just adding sound effects for the background. We're probably going to do different drums. Again, I don't like to like rely on drum breaks because there's just too many inconsistencies in the drum breaks. Let's quantize these hi-hats. And let's turn up what's called swing because we quantized our kicks. Turn these pianos down. All right, now let's start layering some sounds in here. I'm nudging the drums a little to the left so they don't feel so lagged. Same with the hi-hats, they feel a little delayed, so let's pull the hi-hats to the left. Hitting Alt left. Probably gonna add some harder drums, especially the snare. because there's a latency when I'm recording, it's hard to play the drums with the exact timing, so we're not going to keep messing with the drums, so I'm just going to spread them out. See, it's like a delay, so let's quantize. Still feel like these drums are like delayed. Again, we're gonna have to swap out the snare anyway, so I can get obsessed with sound, so let's just keep adding stuff in. For those wondering, I'm using my Korg Kronos for the sounds. Korg Kronos 2. Alright, so that was pretty dope. Okay, so now let's add some dissonance here. Some vibraphones or some kind of bell-based instrument that has a dark tone. We're gonna use half steps. This is a pretty dope sound. So it's like a pad, kind of, but it's a bell. Root note is D. There, I tried a chord. Let's try a lower octave. So the chords sound kind of weird with this. So I'm just playing different things like octaves. Just to switch it up. Okay, so it's all the root note, D in that case. So let's call this like bell pad thing. Just gonna tuck it to the back. So now we're going to play half steps and fifths to create like a melody riff. So we're playing the fifth to the tonic resolution. That was out of key on purpose, but we're not gonna worry about it. Alright, so just spread out bells using the fifth and the tonic to kind of move around. Let's call that like bell synth. And again, you guys will get all the project files for free. Go on to busyworksbeats.com/FLstudio. Let's turn that one down a little loud. It's had some stringed instruments. Now we're adding like dramatic tremolo strings. Just playing D minor and D suspended second. So now we just need like a crazy bell or some kind of wobbly sound. Thank you. It's kind of trying different octaves, perfect fifths, and just that intervallic resolution of the tonic from the fifth to the tonic. So that is called a vibraphone. That is like the staple. That's the sound that most people associate with the Griselda, is that vibraphone sound. So now let's add all like the texture stuff to it. Let's try out the new Wolf compressor on the melodies. Let's group all the melodic and tonal sounds. Sound. Butcher has like some of the best drums for this. So if you guys are looking for drums, look for Beat Butcher. Definitely have the best drum breaks for this vibe. The hard part is you gotta make sure where this is. Actually, it's not hard. Okay, they chopped it properly for us. Let's go back. Turn this down. So I don't want it to repeat constantly, so I might use a different break. I do like the strength of these drums, though. They sound way more full. But let's try one thing. This might be a little repetitive. So I want to go boom, boom, ta, 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 boom, boom, ta, 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 boom, boom, ta, 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 like that, instead of just boom, boom, ta, 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 boom, boom, ta, 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 ta. It just gets a little too repetitive. Again, I probably should take time to find drums that are a little more less kicks. This is very disco. So you could definitely use these drums, but you would have to definitely have to like chop it yourself. So let's try this. I like the drums though. Let's see if we could. I just want to see what this sounds like in context before we just start chopping this up. Let's make sure these drums actually match the vibe. They're a little hi-hat heavy. Griselda doesn't use that much cymbal activity. Hi-hat's a little early too, so nudge it a little. If I only had like a, I would definitely use that. So I'm gonna change up some of the rhythm. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna make a chop. I'll show you guys some techniques. Let's say you like the drum pattern, but it's just doing too much. Grab your slip tool and then change it to the snap to grid to like a beat. And then left click and drag the sample around until you swap that sound out for a different part of the sample. Like a hi-hat, for example. Now, if you can't get to a hi-hat, change it to a smaller increment. So that it's not like a big gap there. So I'm gonna I'm going to do this basically just chopping and pasting sounds. Also, we don't want the sample to overlap, so we're going to slice this part out for volume purposes. So again, I don't like that at the end. So right at the end, let's slice this, grab that slip tool, saves a lot of time, and just left click and drag it until you have a different sample you guys want. So that should fix the drums. So I like these drums a lot better. They don't sound repetitive. We're gonna highlight, hit control, hit shift, left click and drag the entire timing. It's very important to copy your timing. Don't just hit control B because I have gaps in the audio. It does not start on the downbeat. So if you copied and paste, it would be off beat, off the grid. So cool. So Beat Butcher's drums are perfect for the Griselda sound. Let's see if we can add any effects to it with the Roland RE. Let's double click this. Let's hit control L, send these drums to the mixer, and let's send them to the Roland RE as a directly, and then we'll send it. Let's see what kind of presets we have in here. Here. I'm gonna turn the piano off. So we'll add that as a blend just to kind of widen out the drums a bit. Let's start processing the sound. I'm gonna use Gold Clip on the entire track. I forgot to add a bass line. So let's just kind of freestyle a bass. So what I'm going to do is record this bass. having to edit some of these kicks. Cut off a little bit of the hi-hat. guys, let's play this beat twice through. All right, you guys will get the project files for free. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio to get these project files for free. Subscribe if you're new, share with a friend, and leave a comment. Peace.